when we come around. Sweater brother majorly, and I don't know why your girl keeps paging me. Thought I got a problem saying bye-bye, just another hazard of a fly guy. Your ex wife don't matter, my pockets got fatter, and everybody's looking for the ladder. Baby, if you need me, cause I'll be there in a jiffy. Don't be picky, just be happy with this quickie. When will you learn? You can't tie me down, baby, no. And you can tell from my everyday fits, I ain't rich. I'm just another black man caught up in the mix, trying to make a dollar out of it.
A dime and a nickel.
Hey yo, what's up, love? How you doing? Well, I've been hanging, singing, trying to do my thing. Oh, you heard that I was banging, and your cousin thought I wasn't. See, the gift was made for Michelob, but it's a Monday, my day. So just let me hit it, yo, then I get around. Why I call you? Fingertips on the hips as I dip, gotta get a tight grip.
I love the way she licks her lips.
See me drop it, put a little twist in her hips, cause I'm watching. Baby, if you're too fly, don't search for a new guy, cause I only got one night town breakdown. A big clown, baby doll, you down, I get around.
Happy Wednesday to everybody. It's your boy Willie B. We here. I hope everybody is stress free. Move with purpose, I think it's the biggest thing. Know why you're doing what you're doing. Don't just do anything for no reason. We got a legend that's gonna transcend generations. You know, like my kids' kids are gonna know who this guy is, and they're gonna love him. They're gonna revere him. Tupac Shakur.
It's on me, but still I'm having memories of high speeds when the cops crash. As I laugh, pushing the gas when my clocks blast. We was young and we was dumb, but we had heart. In the dark, where we survived through the bad parts.
Manhattan, New York City. He moved from New York to Baltimore, Maryland, and then out to San Francisco, California. I mean, y'all kind of know Tupac's story, you know, the son of a, you know, Black Panther woman. Very smart woman, but, you know, had her struggles with drugs. You know, Tupac eventually he's a dancer. He becomes a dancer, start dancing with a crew called Digital Underground, who I've covered on this show. Shout out to Digital Underground. And this was like Tupac's first, you know, taste of industry, because Digital Underground had, you know, put their foot in the door. He was more so of a backup person, but then he spit a verse on that song, that came out, it's called Same Song.
Been all around the world. Been all around the world.
That was my movie too. I forget the name of it. It got Dan Aykroyd and Chevy Chase. And they actually had Digital Underground in the movie doing the Same Song record off some trippy night roller coaster shit. That shit was fly. Off the success of Digital Underground and him getting this spotlight, he drops an album, which we're covering today. It's called Tupacalypse Now. This comes out in 91 under Interscope Records. Recorded this in Richmond, California. We all know, you know, we know and love Pac for the thug life mentality. He's just a beacon of somebody with so much compassion and so much truth and put action to it. And I think that's why everybody respect and love Tupac, because he just stood for something. And in a world of robots right now, you know, that type of energy and spirit connects to people. It's good to actually listen to a hip-hop, a Tupac album when he's alive. It was like he was still alive when I first heard about him, really, you know. Because I was so young when he died. I think I was like 6 years old when Tupac died. And literally, it didn't seem like he missed a beat, you know, all the way up until my high school. So it's good to hear a project that he actually on purpose made. This nigga Pop come out swinging to me, bruh. Because he's doing a totally different rap style right now. And he understands how to just murder you with it. And he get more swagged out with it as it continues. You know, a simple beat, but Pac was able to find the pockets in that motherfucker to, like, you know, to make it jiggy.
everybody could relate to the feeling of being trapped, I feel like. And that's what makes Pac great. You know, he knows how to just throw themes out there at you that we all are going through. And you're like, yep, that's it. Yeah. And even the, it only, he don't have to have the best beat and rhymes. It's just he got the right theme. This beat is like whatever, though. The beat is ass, but that tells you a lot. If Tupac makes you not even really think about the beat and just what he's talking about, that's the genius of it.
Shit just gonna get worse. Something just gonna come so straight so. All you wanted to be a soldier, a soldier. All you wanted to be
a the beat that I'm like just okay on. Pac comes on. Pac done distorted his voice. I've never heard Pac distort his voice on a record. This is weird because it's kind of giving me a glimpse of maybe where Pac would have went with his shit if he was still alive. Pac would have been, we would have never been able to predict where Pac would have taken his music if he was still alive. He's doing that like deep voice. I've never really heard that in hip hop at this point. Somebody distorting their voice and rapping on the shit. Tupac doing it right here. Speaking common sense at the end of the day, dog. He's like, I'm a human. He's like, what gives you, the police, this like authority over discrimination against me? You know, you come, you violate men, you know, you make them feel less than a man, and they target black men for this. And this is a crazy thing. You know, they want to take our confidence away, you know, and he realizes it. He's like, you want to make me feel like less of a king that I am. And it's like, I'm hip to what you're doing. You know what I mean? And it's like, he said, you got a gun? That's how you feel like a king? Well, then I'm going to carry one too. Love it. Soldier story. It's just about being a soldier at war. I feel like we all are, man. We all soldiers in the war of life. You know, you see people die older. You see people die younger. You see people die the same age. So that's the soldier part of it. Because we all got that expiration date. And you don't know when that shit is coming. So we all just like warriors. It's just like being at war. If you're at war, you know, you're out there with your gun. You're like, I could die today. And then you don't die. You're like, you're still here. And then you live years. But some people are not so fortunate. You see your homie die that same day.
They done pushed me to my limit. I'm all lit. I might blow up anything that did it again. And now I'm in the back of the pack. Bragging why this cop bragging about the nigga he's dead. I see no justice. All I see is niggas dying fast.
What the fuck, dog? I'm glad I came back and listened to this album because this shit right here is way too jiggy for me. Like, this is way too, like, niche, my type of shit right here. The beat is so vibey, yo. Like, I didn't even know they was on this type of jigginess in 91. Pac is different. He's eccentric. You can't put a finger on this nigga for real. The way he came in on this shit, that was like, that's like some jazz scat artist type shit. Sneaky. It's like track 4, you know what I mean? You're not expecting this, but it's just dum 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 dum. And then Pac come in just talking all this reality rap, bro. Like, if you don't listen to Pac and like consider what he's saying. And then the dude he got coming in on it comes in and ripped the shit too. I don't even know who that is. I think he said his name is P.
They claim that I'm violent, just cause I refuse to be silent. These hypocrites are having bitch, cause I'm not buying it, defying it.
Yeah, I'm a little hard when on American hip-hop rappers when we take on like reggae type of beats. Just because like the way they spit on that shit, no American rapper can bring our style to that motherfucker. We could rip it in our way, but if you talk about like the best to do it, we can't even bring it to that level. So every time I hear American rapper do a reggae beat, I'm like, oh, nigga, tread softly. Because if you ain't bringing that motherfucking shit, then you going to get drowned out. And that's kind of what's happening on this record, you know. But Pac is still inserting his, like, you know, fight the power type of message.
Yes, one by one. In one way or another, America will find a way to eliminate the problem one by one. The problem is the troublesome black youth of the ghetto.
This is beautiful right here. This is what makes Pac an icon. Makes him he's a part of the new Bible. If we rewrite the Bible today, we have to put Pac in it. Because of shit like this, because he writes scribe, he put wisdom onto his rhymes. He's not just saying anything. And that's why will forever be immortalized. That's why the Bible is still here. Because, you know, you'd be like, why don't niggas care about these niggas and John and Paul and, you know, all of these people, because it's what they said, bro. They said the most coldest, truest shit that we all have to remember as affirmations to continue to, you know, be happy, to continue to move in a direction with the past in mind, knowing where we come from. That's why if you don't know history, it's hard to build a future. Because you don't know where the fuck you come from. You know what you stand for. You don't have no real purpose. And this joint is just so jazzy, bro, and it's dope. It's dope. I couldn't wait for him to start spitting on it because he like did some preacher shit at the beginning. And then he came spitting and you knew he was going to rip this shit. Like how black men take shit, you know, because it ain't like we don't see shit. You know, it's a way you got to go about things, especially when you know the history. And that's kind of what Tupac is talking about. He like, yo, Martin Luther King out here talking about get slapped in the face and nonviolent, like he's like, and just keep on preaching that shit, like this integrity to not be physically dominating, but to play a more of a mental dominating game. If this is the thing, it's dominating just to be seen. It's not dominating to possess you or rule you. And like that's where the conflict happens, because us as humans, we on our get back mode a lot. So, you know, revenge is the best story. So it's hard to have the integrity to have all of the tools you need to be have the perfect revenge, but then do the right thing with it. Pac is just so good at his lead-ins. You know, I'm an actor, and I talked about this once before, but like one of my good actor teachers told me it's all about the first thing you say, the way you come into a thing, you know, especially when you're making art and making hip-hop, your like thesis statement, that first thing you say out your mouth. And that's why literally when I write songs, it'll take me forever just to write the first line. And then after I write the first line, it just flow like water. You know what I mean? But literally writing that first line, I could sit with a beat for months to years before just that first line even comes out. I don't know what to write. Very tribal in its beat sounds. I'm like that though. I like monkey fuck tribal beats. That, you know, like if I went to Ghana and it's just a nigga on the fucking in the back doing some crazy shit, that's my soul. But, you know, if you don't like tribal sounds and like heavy Congo, and I love go-go, I'm from DC, I love go-go. So it's like, you know, if you don't like that, the beauty and the jumble up of drums and music, if you can't hear it, if you can't feel it, you're not gonna like this record. But for me, I really fuck with it.
Smoking ass nigga about me blunt. I got a tech nine, now a smoking ass is mine. I guess I felt sorry for the fact that he was broke. I didn't know he slut, so I didn't want to broke. He caught me on the sneak.
Feeling my little liquor now. Alright. Don't judge me, goddamn. Alright. I told y'all, you know, it's off some drink champs type shit. I gotta. But that's the thing, like, it's been beats on here that they've given Pac that was trash, in my sense, but he worked with it and made it not trash. See, Pac's ear is crazy, you know what I mean? Because he's so eclectic. Even a record like this, it's like a crossover record, but it's still just fucking, you believe him, you trust him. You know, that's the thing about Pac. You know, he not steering you wrong. He just gave you so much truth. You think on a record like this, where he going to do a pop record, he going to give you some bullshit? It's like, you're not even expecting that. Beautiful piano to come in there. It sound like a sample, but I don't know if it is. I think they just, it's like, it's inspired by a sample. But it almost sound like, get ready tonight. Gonna make this a night to remember. Like when the piano come in on that shit, this kind of sound like those piano tones. It bring a beautiful texture to the song. Yeah, baby. you know, Brenda's got a baby. You know, this is like one of the biggest tracks on his that put him in the limelight because he's talking the realest thing. And I don't think anybody's ever got this in depth on women and their having a child and then dealing with this particular issue of a woman throwing away her baby. I don't want this baby anymore. And this is a touchy subject, but I respect women too in that way. I respect that thought of not wanting to have my child anymore. I don't demonize women for having that thought. This is the most terrible thing you could do. I demonize the action of it, but I don't demonize the feeling, you know. Because even my mother told me that she's surprised I'm still here. I talk to, you know, my childhood, I can't see it, but the way she see it, she like, nigga, I could have ended your shit thousands of times, and I didn't. I don't know if that's KC and JoJo on the hook, but it really sounds like it.
Oh shit, jumped on my man's dick. Heard he had a 12-inch, now the bitch is lusty. Who's the blank? The guy or the groupie? Heard I was down with D.U., now she wants to dupe me.
He giving you them type. He giving you jab bars, you know what I mean? And just coming for you. I love this Pac. This is like, I never really heard this Pac. You know what I mean? And trust me, I've never really dove completely into a Pac album. That's why this is a good moment for me, because it's like, damn. And it's the lunatic shit. He just going deranged. You know, he's going insane on it. It's no full direction. It's just, he's just speaking his mind. Man, I really love this record. This is like watching Floyd Mayweather just go on offense. He's give you three verses of just fucking fire.
They just can't stand the rain or be.
It's got that digital underground feeling. This is the first record another record too, but I feel like this is like the second record that I feel that Shock G and them had a real imprint on, because this feels like that digital underground vibe. He gotta give it up to the crew that sprung him, you know.
She's a part-time.
He's literally talking about his mother being addicted to crack and the effect that had on him, but mama, I got this, you know. And that's such a like a 360 all around kind of view, because some people just get stuck in one view, like, and they couldn't even like describe that to nobody. And that's what makes Pac so different. It's like, how do you know that that's a thing and then compartmentalize it to make it art? Very translatable to where you can talk it to somebody. Not just paint it, but you can say it out of your mouth with articulate words. Album concept and theme, Tupacalypse Now. What he talking about is the same shit we talking about today. Inspiration of the movie, Apocalypse Now. It's inspiration comes from that. Kind of giving you a warning of like where we at, you know, 20 years later. You know, it's urgent. This album matters. Album concept and theme is very accurate. So much truth on this album, and it's very jiggy. Even beyond black skin, which it does touch on. It's just about humanity problems and really going deeper. He doesn't play the victim. He's not the black victim on this, but of course he's going to play the race card because it's so prevalent, but he doesn't speak from a victim's point of view. He speaks from what we're going to do on the offense. The artwork for me, I feel like it's definitely supposed to be gritty. It's supposed to have that feel. It has it, but it has a low budget feel also to it. It's mixtapey for sure. Like, you know how you look at a mixtape cover and you're like, oh, but you're not looking for the mixtape to impress you. We just want the music. Fuck all the, you know, you don't have to have the greatest thing, but this is his first album. So if I'm going to judge it from a standpoint of, you know, the album covers that exist, it's very low. Production is interesting because on one end of the spectrum, a lot of it was very low sounding. It wasn't a lot of thump. I wish I would have had more thump in this album, more, you know, just sound. Because if you enhance the sounds of this album, Lord knows. Like, if you can make this album with the same beats and everything, but sound like a Bryson Tiller album, what the fuck? But Pac is just such an incredible artist that he can make any beat a hit. You can throw him trash and he will give you gold. Creativity is high because, I mean, Tupac is way too creative with the way he just switches himself up. The ultimate chameleon. You don't know exactly how he's going to present himself. He did some new things in this album that I've never heard in early 90s albums or 80s albums. He's changing the game. He's moving it forward. Off that alone, I'm going to go with a 9. 8 out of these 13 songs, dog, are worth coming back to listen to. For sure. So replay value is, needless to say, very high for me. I'm gonna go with a 10 in replay value. Like, you must listen to this. Impact to the culture and the game, very high also. But, you know, they're building on what groups like X-Clan did, what groups like Public Enemy did. You know, he's really building on that ideology and legacy, but adding a different obtuseness to it. Lyrics, what the fuck? 10, dog, come on. 10. You talking about 91 to hear this dude spitting like the fuck he spit? He's your favorite rapper. He's your favorite rapper now. Whoever was your favorite rapper in 91, when he came out, it was like, okay, there's a new one. This is gonna be a first time. This album scored a 59 by the numbers. But just because it's Pac, and I gave him no points for being deceased early before his time, I'm gonna give him just that 1 point because it's where that falls is, it's a good album, a really good album. But I'm gonna give him the point because it's 1 point away from a classic. I'm gonna give him the point just because he didn't have a chance. So we're gonna bump that up 1 point to a 60. It's a base level classic. Boom. That's unprecedented. It probably will only happen for deceased rappers who didn't get a chance to have longevity and make that long lasting impression. He gets the point. It's a classic. Shout out to Tupac. Shout out to Digital Underground. Shout out to everybody who produced on this. Shout out to Interscope Records. Shout out to you for watching this. Stay safe. We're going to keep trotting through this week. And I holler.